In this video, I'm going to discuss one of the most requested topics from that human physiology. That is the structure of the ear. Actually, I know that everybody know what is the ear and where is the ear is situated and what is the structure. Like, you know that thing, the ear is divided into external ear, internal ear and middle ear there. And many of you know what is there in the external ear and middle ear, but the structure of the internal ear is very much complicated. And many of you are having a lot of confusion. So in this video, I'm going to clear everything related to the internal ear, especially the structure of cochlea and the mechanism of hearing. So you have to watch the video completely to understand the mechanism of hearing in proper, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. So you know that the ear is divided into external ear, middle ear and inner ear, and I think like most of you know about the external ear and middle ear, and the problem lies within the inner ear, right? So let's go to the inner ear. So you can see that this part which I am focusing now, this is that inner ear. Actually, this part is the inner ear. And you have to understand one thing very importantly, that you can see the ear as such, entire ear is situated within a bone. You can see, I will mark a bone here. Can you see that thing? In every figure of the ear, you can see that the ear is situated within a bone there. Can you see that? But which is that bone which is situated, which is that ear is lying within? You can see that bone is this bone that is known as the temporal bone. You know that the cranial bone here within the temporal bone. So the temporal bone, there is a cavity like that, there is a cave like thing, and within this cavity, within that cavity of the temporal bone, the ear is lying there. Okay, that's the point number one. You have to remember the ear is situated within the temporal bone. So you can see that here I have written here that thing, the situation of the ear. You can write down that the ear is situated within the temporal bone. Ear is situated within the temporal bone here. That is a point number one you have to remember. And whenever we are talking about the ear, or whenever you are reading your NCERT textbook, you can see a word which is related to ear here. What is that word which is confusing you? That is known as the labyrinth. The word is known as what? Labyrinth. What is the actual meaning of labyrinth? You have to understand that thing. The actual meaning of labyrinth is inner ear. You have to know the meaning of labyrinth is what? Inner ear. So wherever you are seeing the word labyrinth, you can replace the word labyrinth with inner ear. You can replace the word labyrinth with what? Inner ear. So if you are replacing the word inner ear to the labyrinth there, you will be getting the meaning here. Okay, right? You have to understand. So let me show you another clear picture of the inner ear. So I am just focusing here. This is the very clear picture of the inner ear. You can see that the inner ear, which is situated within the bone. What is that bone there? This bone is the temporal bone. I have shown you that is the temporal bone here. And within the inner ear, you can see there are two parts. That's very important. Ear is a sensory organ. It is to analyze some sensations there. So within the inner ear, there are two portions there. So I will be separating this two portion. The first portion is this one. Can you see that thing? The first portion is this one. This one, that is the first portion. This first portion, that is known as what? That is known as vestibular apparatus. That is known as what? Vestibular apparatus. And you have to understand that thing. The vestibular apparatus is the sense organ for balancing. It is a sense organ. Very important. This is a sense organ. So in this video, I am mainly focusing on the cochlea, the second part here. You can see this is the second part here. Can you see the second part, the coiled part there? There is something like a snail, just a coiled part. The second part is known as what? Cochlea. The second part is known as cochlea. So this is a sense organ for sound. It is a sense organ for sound there. Sound. So in this video, I will be mainly focusing on the structure of the cochlea and the mechanism of hearing, and I will be posting another video for that vestibular apparatus and the mechanism of balancing of our body. Okay, so let us go to the cochlea in detail there. So I will draw a cochlea for you for your understanding. So you know that thing, the cochlea is something like a coiled tube. It is like a coiled tube here. Can you see that thing? So this is a tube. You can see that this is a tube here which is coiled like that. And for our understanding, what I'm going to do, I'm going to unroll this tube. So I'm going to draw the tube as a straight tube there. Are you understanding that thing? There was a straight tube and the tube was coiled like that, and it was placed here. That is a cochlea there. I am going to unroll this tube and I am going to draw like that. So when I am drawing, when I am going to unroll this tube, it will be going like this thing. You can see that thing, that was a tube here and the tube was going like this. Can you see? Are you understanding? So this was a tube here. This is a cochlear tube, which I have drawn like it is unrolled there. Clear that? And what is outside this tube? What is outside this tube? Can you tell me what is outside this tube? I told you that the entire thing, entire inner ear, that is made up of bone. So just outside this tube, which I am drawing now, this area is made up of bone. You have to understand this area, which is present outside, which I am marking in yellow now. This is made up of what? This is made up of what? Bone. There, this is made up of bone. So actually, which bone? That bone is the temporal bone. I have already told you this is a tube which is made up of bone there. So you can see that thing, that is the inner ear tube which is made up of bone. So we'll be calling this tube as a bony tube. We'll be calling it as a bony tube, or we'll be calling it as a bony inner ear. We will be calling it as what? We will be calling it as bony inner ear. Bony inner ear. So what will be the actual word for the bony inner ear? I told you a name, I told you a word for the inner ear. What was that thing? It is known as what? Bony labyrinth. It is known as what? Bony labyrinth. Bony labyrinth. That means bony inner ear, simply because it is made up of a tube. So that will be a long tube which is made up of bone. That is known as bony labyrinth. Is that clear? Okay, that's the point number one. And within the bony labyrinth, within the bony tunnel there, you can see that there will be two membranes. How many membranes are there? Two membranes are there. So I'll be drawing the first membrane. This is the first membrane here. I'll be drawing one membrane here. Okay, this is the one membrane, and this is the second membrane. I will be marking two membranes here. Can you see that thing? So there is a membrane number one and there is a membrane number two. There are two membranes which is situated within that bony labyrinth, within that bony labyrinth. So there will be an upper membrane and a lower membrane. Upper membrane and lower membrane. What is the name of the upper membrane? What is the name of the upper membrane? Upper membrane is known as the membrane number one, which I have marked there. It is known as what? It is known as resinous membrane. It is known as resinous membrane. It is known as resinous membrane. And the lower membrane, okay, that is a clue here. You have to understand the membrane is lower, or I will be calling it as a basal membrane. You know that the basal level, that is a lower level, the basal membrane, it is known as what? It is known as the basilar membrane. It is known as basilar membrane. So you have to understand there are two membranes are there. There is an upper resinous membrane and a lower basilar membrane is there. And you have to understand a very, very important point that is not mentioned in any books, but you have to understand this is the actual practice. Whenever the upper resinous membrane and lower basilar membrane, which is reaching at the end, you have to understand these two membranes are interconnected. These two membranes are interconnected. So just see that thing here. You can see the upper and lower membrane, which is coming here, the resinous membrane, which is coming here like this, and it is continued with the lower basilar membrane. Can you see that? So the upper resinous membrane and lower basilar membrane, both of them together, it is making another tube here. Can you see? This is another tube here. So this is a tube which I am marking here. Can you see that thing? That is a tube which is made up of membrane. Where is that membranous tube is lying? The membranous tube is lying within the bony tube. Can you see the outer one, which I have marked in yellow? That is a bony tube that was known as a bony labyrinth. Within the bony tube, there is a tube which is made up of membrane. How many membranes? Two membranes are there. The upper membrane is known as resinous membrane, and the lower membrane or basal membrane is known as the basilar membrane. This is making a membranous tube. So that tube, it is known as what? That is known as membranous inner ear. That is known as what? Membranous inner ear. That means that is known as what? Membranous labyrinth. Membranous labyrinth. So where is the membranous labyrinth is lying? Membranous labyrinth is lying within the bony labyrinth. The membranous labyrinth is lying within the bony labyrinth there. So I am erasing all these things. So I have to discuss furthermore. So there are two membranes, resinous membrane and basilar membrane. And this is making a membranous labyrinth, which is lying within the bony labyrinth there. Is that clear? You have to know it very, very well. Okay, and here you have to understand these two labyrinths, the bony labyrinth and membranous labyrinth, that is filled with a fluid. What is the name of the fluid? The fluids are known as lymph. The fluid is known as what? Lymph there. And the fluid which is filling inside the membranous labyrinth, that means the fluid which is present here, you can see that thing, the fluid which is present here, that is filling inside the membranous labyrinth here. This fluid, what is the name of this fluid? Because it is present inside the membranous labyrinth, this fluid which is present here, that is known as what? That is known as endo endolymph. Endo means inside, right? So the fluid which is present inside, that is known as what, endolymph here. And there is some fluid which is filling outside the membranous labyrinth, outside the membranous labyrinth. That means here, you can see that thing, this area. Can you see that thing? This area which I am marking in green here, that is situated outside the membranous labyrinth here, right? So that area is filled with another fluid that is known as what? That is known as what? Perilymph. That is known as what? Perilymph. There are two types of lymphs are there. Two types of lymph are there. One lymph is known as endolymph, which is present inside the membranous labyrinth. And there is another lymph that is present outside the membranous labyrinth, that is known as perilymph. So I have marked only one area. You can see this area. This area, that is, this is also outside the membranous labyrinth. So this is also filled by perilymph here. Can you see that thing? And also in at the end here, there is also perilymph here. Can you see? So that labyrinth is filled with the lymphs there. So the end membranous labyrinth is filled inside by endolymph and outside by perilymph. You can see that thing. Are you understanding? This is very, very, very important thing. And that is the basic data. And I have to add some more data here. You have to pay full attention here. Otherwise, you will not understand this thing. Okay. You have to pay full attention here. We can see this chamber is divided into three parts. You can see that total bony labyrinth is here. So that is divided into three parts. The part number one, the part number two, and part number three. Can you see that thing? So there is an upper chamber, there is a middle chamber, and there is a lower chamber. Can you see that thing? So that these things are divided into three chambers are there. There is an upper chamber, middle chamber, and lower chamber. So what is making the upper chamber? You can see that thing. This is the bony labyrinth. There is a bony tube here and the resinous membrane here. These two things, the bone and the resinous membrane, is marking the upper chamber. And the second chamber is made by the resinous membrane, the upper membrane, and that basilar membrane, the lower membrane. That is the second part here. And the third part, it is made by the basilar membrane here and the bone here. That is making the third chamber here. So there are three chambers are there: the upper chamber, middle chamber, and lower chamber. So what is the name of this chamber? That is also very, very important for you. The upper chamber, the upper chamber. So I will be marking here the upper chamber here, the upper chamber, that is known as what? Scala. That is known as what? Scala. What is the word meaning of scala? Scala means chamber. You have to understand the scala means what? Chamber there. The upper chamber is known as scala vestibuli. It is known as what? Scala vestibuli. How will you remember this thing? Simple. You can remember like UV, like ultraviolet. You will be remembering like ultraviolet here. What is that thing? UV, upper vestibuli. You have to remember like upper vestibule. So what will be the name of the middle chamber here? It's very simple, right? So you know that thing. The chamber means what? What do you mean by chamber? Chamber means scala. You can write here scala. Because it is middle, we will be calling it as scala media. It is known as what? Scala media. So the upper scala vestibule and the middle one is known as what? Scala media. Upper chamber is known as scala vestibule. You can remember like UV, and the middle one is known as what? Scala media there. And the lower one, what is the name of the lower one? The lower one, it is known as what? Scala tympani. This name you have to remember. That is known as what? Scala tympani. But it will be very easy, because if you are remembering the upper one as scala vestibuli and the middle one as scala media, then the last one will be scala tympani there. Because in every options, in every MCQs, you will be getting all the three together, and you have to arrange it upper, middle, and lower. So upper is vestibuli, middle is media, then the lower one will be automatically tympani. You don't have to get confused about that thing. So I will revise everything once again. You can see that our inner ear, our cochlea, is made up of a bony tube outside, which is made in temporal bone. That is known as bony labyrinth. And within the bony labyrinth, there is a membranous labyrinth here. There is a membranous labyrinth here. So that is made up of two membranes, the upper resinous membrane and basilar membrane. Two are there, and these two membranes are connected at the end. So that is making a membranous tube. So that is within that bony labyrinth, there is a membranous labyrinth is there. And there are two lymphs are there. One lymph is filling inside the membranous labyrinth. That is known as endolymph. One lymph is filling outside the membranous labyrinth, that is known as perilymph there. Okay, and you can see that thing, these two membranes is dividing the total chamber into three chambers are there. There is an upper chamber, middle chamber, and lower chamber. The upper chamber is known as scala vestibuli, the middle chamber is known as scala media, and lower chamber is known as scala tympani there. Is that clear? And one last question here, what is the fluid which is filling the scala vestibuli? Can you tell me which is the scala vestibuli? The upper chamber. What is the fluid which is filling the scala vestibuli there? Can you tell me that? Can you tell me? You can see that this is the scala vestibule here. The scala vestibule is filled with a fluid there. What was the fluid there? That fluid is your perilymph. You can see that thing. That is perilymph is filling. Perilymph is filling the scala vestibuli. Clear? Same way, what is the fluid which is filling the scala media? You can see the scala media is this area. This area is filled with the one fluid that is known as what? That is known as endolymph. That is known as what? Endolymph. Endolymph is filling the scala media there. Same way, if I am asking what is the fluid which is filling the scala tympani, let's just look at that thing. The scala tympani, it is filled by the perilymph. Can you see that? It is filled by the perilymph here. So there are three chambers are there. Each of the chamber is filled with a fluid there. So perilymph is filling two chambers. Which are the two chambers which is filled by the perilymph? The perilymph is filled by the scala vestibuli and the scala tympani. Scala vestibuli and scala tympani, both are filled by the perilymph, and the endolymph is present in only one chamber, which is the chamber that is the scala media. Scala media is filled with the endolymph there. Clear that? So I will draw this figure again, and I will be talking something more about the cochlea and about the mechanism of hearing here. So you can see different structures are there. What is the thing which I have marked in yellow here? What is the outer tube is known as? That is known as the bony labyrinth. I will just write in here, that is the bony labyrinth. And within that you can see the two membranes are there. So there is the upper membrane. What is the name of the upper membrane here? The first membrane here, that is known as the resinous membrane. The upper membrane is known as the resinous membrane, and the lower membrane, that is known as the basilar membrane here, and that is making a membranous labyrinth inside. And you can see there are three chambers. Which are the three chambers? The first chamber is this one, second one is this one, third one is this one. What is the name of the upper chamber? Upper chamber is known as scala vestibuli. Upper chamber is known as scala vestibuli. Middle chamber is known as what? Scala media. Lower chamber is known as scala tympani there. Can you see that thing? There are three chambers are there, and there are some lymphs are filling here. What is the lymph which is filling the scala vestibuli? I told you that is a perilymph is filling. And what is the lymph which is filling the scala media? The middle one, that is filled by endolymph. And what is the fluid which is filling the scala tympani? That is filled by the perilymph again. You can see that thing. So this was all thing we have discussed here till now. And I want to tell you something about the structure of the ear. You know that thing, the ear is having the middle ear and external ear also. So what is happening to the sound wave which is hitting our external ear? You know that thing, this thing is the pinna, and I have shown the pinna here. You can see, suppose this is a sound wave which is coming here in the pinna. What the pinna will do? The pinna will collect all the sound waves, and all the sound waves will be directed towards the external auditory canal here. I think you know this thing, you have to study that. And the sound wave will be coming towards the external auditory canal, and it will be hitting on the tympanic membrane. So the tympanic membrane will vibrate according to that sound wave, and when it is coming here, that will be transmitted to three bony ossicles. Which are the three bony ossicles? The first one, it is known as the malleus. The second one, it is known as the incus. And the third one, the smallest one, that is known as what? The stapes there. The stapes there. So the code here is MIS. Malleus, incus, stapes. So the malleus, the first, the sound wave, when the tympanic membrane vibrates, first the malleus will vibrate, then the incus will vibrate, and the vibrations are passed on to the stapes there. And you have to understand a very, very important thing. The stapes is attached. The stapes is attached to a window here. There is an opening here, and that opening which will be going to the scala vestibuli. Can you see that thing? Can you see that thing? That opening which will be going into the scala vestibuli. And what is the opening where that stapes is attached? What is the name of that opening where the stapes is attached? That is known as the oval window. That is known as what? Oval window. And you can see, you have to understand, the oval window is an opening towards the scala vestibuli there. You have to understand, the oval window is an opening towards the scala vestibuli. So I will teach you a code here. You have to understand, the code is like MISOV. What is that thing? MISOV. You have to remember like that. So you know, when the tympanic membrane vibrates, first that malleus will vibrate, then the incus will vibrate, then the stapes will vibrate. Stapes is connected through the oval window to the vestibuli there. So what will happen? The vibrations will reach the scala vestibuli. You have to understand, very, very, very important thing. So from the external ear, the sound waves will come, tympanic membrane will vibrate, then the malleus, then the incus, then the stapes. Stapes is connected to the oval window, and the oval window is an opening towards the scala vestibuli. Very, very important thing. So what will happen to the vibrations? Very simple thing. Through the oval window, the vibrations will reach the scala vestibuli, and you can see that thing, the scala vestibuli is filled by what fluid? That is filled by perilymph, and the vibrations will be passing through the perilymph here. You have to understand. And when it is reaching at the end of the cochlea, you can see that thing, when it is reaching at the end of the cochlea, what will happen to these vibrations? These vibrations will turn towards the scala tympani. Can you see?
because the scala vestibuli and scala tympani is connected at the end, the sound waves will come back here, and the sound waves will be going towards the perilymph. It will be going through the perilymph, and can you see that thing? That is also filled by perilymph through the scala tympani. It will reach here at the end here. So what will happen to the sound waves again here? You have to understand, there should be an opening for the sound wave to go out. Otherwise, what will happen? The sound wave will reflect. It will hit here and it will reflect back, and reflecting waves will be getting interference with that upcoming waves. That will be causing problem in hearing. For to avoid that thing, there should be an exit opening for the sound wave there. What is the exit opening? The exit opening is here. You have to understand that is in the scala tympani here. Through that exit opening, the sound wave will go out into the middle ear, and it will be getting dissipated in the middle ear. So what is the name of the opening? What is the name of the opening of the scala tympani? This is known as the round window. That is known as what? Round window. So I am going more detail here. You have to understand, the oval window is an opening of the scala vestibuli. Oval window is the opening of the scala vestibuli, and through the oval window, the sound waves is going into the cochlea. You have to understand, through the oval window, the sound wave is going into the cochlea, into the scala vestibuli, and through the scala vestibuli, you can see that here, through the scala vestibuli, the sound waves will be traveling. It will be traveling, and at the end of the cochlea, the sound wave will get into the scala tympani. It will go into that scala tympani, and it is going through the scala tympani, and at the end there is a round window. Through the round window, the sound wave will be going out. So the sound wave is going into cochlea through the oval window, and it is going out through the round window. You have to understand, it is going out through the round window. Very, very, very important here. Are you understanding? So what will happen as the sound waves are moving together here? There will be ripples, there will be waves or ripples will be created in the perilymph and in the endolymph. In the endolymph and perilymph, there will be waves will be created according to the sound waves will be there. And what will the waves will be doing? You have to know the actual structure of the hearing organ here. For that purpose, what I am going to do, I am going to cut this bony tube like this. You have to understand, suppose this pen is a bony tube here. This was going like that. I am going to cut it like that, and I am going to show to you like this thing here. So what is there here? What is that thing? So I am going to cut this tube like that. So when I'm cutting this tube like this thing, what will you see? You will be seeing the cut section of the tube. What is the cut section of the tube will be looking like? Since it is a tube, it will be looking like a round shape here, right? You have to understand, there will be a round cut shape will be there, and within that thing you can see there will be two membranes. You can see the upper membrane here. Can you see that thing? There will be an upper membrane and there will be a lower membrane will be there, which is dividing the tube into three. So I'm just drawing the upper membrane here. This is the upper membrane. This is just a diagrammatic diagram. What is the name of the upper membrane? The upper membrane is known as a resinous membrane, and the lower membrane which I am drawing here, that is known as what? Basilar membrane. So it is dividing the tube into three chambers there. What are the three chambers? You can see the upper chamber is known as scala vestibuli, middle one is known as scala media, and the lower one is known as scala tympani. It will be divided here. So the resinous membrane and basilar membrane will be dividing into three chambers here. So you have to understand. And what are the fluids which is there? There will be the perilymph will be here. Here is also filled by perilymph, and this will be filled by the endolymph here. I hope you are understanding. And this figure is given in your NCRT figure. Are you understanding this figure? So I know that this figure is given in your NCRT figure here. So just focus that thing. This is the figure in your NCRT textbook, and this is what I am exactly what I was doing here. So that was a cut section of the cochlear tube, and it is divided into two like this thing. The upper membrane is known as resinous membrane. The lower membrane is known as basilar membrane. This is a scala vestibuli. This is a scala media, and this is scala tympani there. Just look into this figure, you will be understanding this thing. Okay, so just see that thing. This is a scala vestibule. It is marked here. This is upper chamber. This is the resinous membrane, the upper membrane which is going like that. This is the resinous membrane, and this is a scala media, that is a middle membrane. And you can see there is a lower scala tympani also marked here, right? So you have to know how that sound waves are going here. You know, the through the scala vestibuli, the sound waves are going through like that. It will be going like that, and through the scala tympani, the sound waves will be coming back like this thing. So what will happen? So I will be going back again here in this figure. What will be happening? There will be vibrations will be created on the membranes. Which membrane? On the resinous membrane and basilar membrane, on the perilymph, endolymph, and perilymph, and everywhere there will be vibrations will be there, and that will be sensed. Who will be sensing that vibrations? For that purpose, we are having a special organ here, the organ for hearing, that is known as what? Organ of Corti. Organ of
Corti is here, organ of Corti. What do you mean by organ of Corti and where it is situated? You have to understand the organ of Corti is a special organ for hearing that is situated on the basilar membrane. So I will be just drawing the basilar membrane for your understanding, okay, to understand what is organ of Corti and how it is hearing here. You have to understand, suppose this is the basilar membrane, okay, I will be just drawing, this is the basilar membrane here, you have to understand, this is the basilar membrane, and on the basilar membrane, what is present here, you have to understand, there are some cells are present, some specialized cells are there, and what is the speciality of the cell, these cells will be having some hairs over that thing, some hairs will be there, and these cells are known as hair cells, these cells are known as what, hair cells are there, you have to understand, there is basilar membrane, over that, there are some hair cells are there, and over the hair cell, you have to understand, there is another membrane is present here. Can you see that thing? There will be another membrane is present like this here. That is known as what? This membrane is a special membrane that is known as tectorial membrane. You have to understand. This is a special thing. Okay, so you can see two special structures which I have drawn here. What are the two special structures which I have drawn here? One is this tectorial membrane and the hair cell. Can you see the tectorial membrane and hair cell? Where it is situated? It is situated above the basilar membrane. And these structures, the tectorial membrane and hair cell, this is known as your organ of Corti. And what it will be doing? You have to understand that thing. The sound waves will be passing. I told you, right? So the sound waves will be coming through here, and it will be coming here, and it will be going through these lymphs here. So when the sound wave is going through the lymph here, what will be occurring? The basilar membrane was like that. That will be having ripples. That will be having the waves will be created over the basilar membrane like that. So when the waves are there, what will be occurring? Above the waves, there are the hair cells are there. Suppose these fingers are like hairs. The hair cells will be moving up and down like that. As that basilar membranes are moving, as the basilar membrane is moving above and down, the hair cell will also moving above and down like that. Are you understanding? So when the hair cells are moving up and down like that, above the hair cell, who is present? The tectorial membrane is there. So what will be occurring? The hair cells will move up. It will hit over the tectorial membrane. When it is hitting over the tectorial membrane, it will bend like that. The hair cell will be bending because the hair is very fine, right? You have to understand. On the basilar membrane, the hair cells are there. So when the sound waves are passing like that, the basilar membrane will be moving like this, the hair cell will be moving up and down like that. So when the hair cells are moving up and down like that, it will move up, it will hit over the tectorial membrane. When it is hitting there, the hair cell will bend here. You have to understand, the hair cell will bend. So I will make a simple flow chart with the organ of Corti. You will be understanding. So sound waves moving in perilymph, that the first thing you have to write down it in the perilymph, the sound waves are moving, so that is the first thing. And when the sound waves are moving in perilymph, there will be ripples or waves will be created, waves in basilar membrane. You have to write down this thing, okay, waves in basilar membrane. So when the waves are created in the basilar membrane, you have to know, when the waves are created in the basilar membrane, what will be occurring? These waves will move hair cell up and down. It will move up and down. So when it is moving up and down, what will be occurring? The hair cell hit on tectorial membrane. So what will be occurring? You have to understand, the hair hit on the tectorial membrane and the hair bends. The hairs will be bending. You have to understand, the hair is hitting and it will be bending. And this bending of the hair, you have to understand, this will be acting as a stimulus. And this stimulus will be converted to a nerve impulse. You have to understand. Very, 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 very important thing. So the hair cell will be bending. The bending of the hair will be acting as a stimulus here, and that will be creating that there will be nerve endings will be connected to this thing, and through the nerve endings, that will be converted as a nerve stimulus, and that will be travel to the brain. And when the brain is receiving these impulses, how the impulse is created? The impulse is created according to the sound wave. So when the sound wave is coming, it will be going hitting, it will be creating that nerve impulse. When the brain is receiving, brain will be interpreting it as a sound there. That's how we will will be hearing here. You can see that thing. You can see here in this figure, you can see the hair cells. Can you see that thing? You can see in the organ of Corti, it is generally marked as organ of Corti. You can see that hair cells here, and you can see the tectorial membrane which is going above it, and you can see a lot of nerve fibers. Can you see the yellow thing? This is the nerve, and this will be going to the brain, and the brain will be interpreting it as a sound wave here. That's how you will be hearing the sound. So once again I just want to tell you what is happening in the cochlea. There the cochlea is a bony tube. Within that there is a membranous tube is there. The membranous tube is made up of two membranes, the upper resinous, lower basilar membrane, and that will be dividing into three chambers: the scala vestibuli, scala media, and scala tympani. And the scala vestibuli and scala tympani is filled by perilymph, and the scala media is filled by endolymph, and the sound waves are moving through that malleus incus tapis. This code is very, very important. Just remember that thing: malleus incus tapis through the oval window into the vestibuli. So it will be reaching in the vestibuli, it will be finally coming into that scala tympani here. It will be finally coming into the scala tympani. When the sound waves are moving, the basilar membrane will move up and down. When the basilar membrane move up and down, the hair cell will move up and down. The hair cell will move up and down. It will hit over that tectorial membrane. It will bend. The bending will be generating a nerve impulse. It will go to the brain. Brain will be interpreting it as a sound there. I hope you are understanding this structure here. And if in case of any doubt, please comment below on the comment box. And if you don't like the video, just tell me why you don't like the video also. And if you like it, put a like and consider subscribing my channel here. I'll be posting the next videos on this topic and every other topic. And if you need any more topic, you can ask that also there. Bye bye. We'll meet you on the next video there.